For the next topic, let's start by doing a little bit of a thought exercise. Let's think about writing a program that takes command line parameters according to the following usage text or help text. So it's a program that takes some options and then a file name. So the file name has to be there. The options are optional. And the two valid options are dash A and dash B. So for instance, here are some valid commands. So all of them include a file. Some of them, one of them doesn't include any flags. This one has one flag. This has two flags. This has two flags, but together in one option, which is generally considered to be valid. Here are some invalid commands. So the first one doesn't include a file name. The second one also doesn't include a file name. And this one includes a flag that's not valid. So it would be useful here to sit for a minute and think about how you would write code in C to check and make sure that these that the command line parameters are valid, and how you would extract all of that information once you had verified that it was valid, or as you were verifying that it was valid. So if you actually did sit down and think about it for a little while, you'd probably come up with something that looks roughly like this. So this is a loop that sort of iterates over argv. So argc is the number of things in argv. And we just look at each of the things in turn, and we look at sort of the second character, because that's going to be the flag, right? So we'll ignore the dash and we'll look at the next thing. If it's A, then you know we'll save the value of A flag. We'll say, hey, we saw an A, so we'll keep that. If we see a B, then we'll see a B flag. If it's something other than B, we will report an error. And then we'll save the last parameter as the file name. And so, you know, this is a decent first stab at this, but there are actually a lot of holes and problems with this code. There are a lot of things that could go wrong, and so you should maybe think a little bit about what might go wrong here. Here are some problems. So, you know, what if there is no file name at the end? Then this reference here is not going to be valid, or is going to refer to something that's not the file name. How would you, what if there are two file names? How do you handle parameters or combined flags? What if there is no second argument or second character? What if there's only one character in one of the flags? There's just a lot of corner cases that you have to deal with. So most programs accept some sort of command line parameters in Linux. And so this is something that people have, that a lot of people have needed, and there have been various solutions over the years so that everyone doesn't have to roll their own. And the better way that we're going to recommend in this course is something called GitOpt. There is a newer version called GitOpt Long. We're going to basically use the simpler version. So we're just going to use GitOpt. And GitOpt is basically a function that sort of chops up your argv and returns all of the important information to you while doing all of the error handling so that you don't have to worry about it yourself. And so the idea is that you're going to call GitOpt repeatedly, and every time that GitOpt returns, it's going to return one of the flags, even when they're grouped or out of order. And then when there are no more flags, it's going to return a negative one. So this allows you to pull out each flag in general. Now you need to tell it which flags are valid. So you need to pass in something called an opt string, which is a list of the valid flags. So for instance, an opt string of ABC indicates that dash A, dash B, and dash C are all valid flags, and any combination would be valid as well. And if you have a flag that takes a parameter, so if, for instance, you want people to be able to say, you know, dash in four, then you put a colon after that letter. There are a couple of global variables that GitOpt sets to help make it easier for you to get more information. So opt-arg is going to be a pointer to the string parameter for flags that take them. So for instance, if you get a flag of n back from GitOpt, and it has a parameter, then opt-arg is going to be a pointer to that particular parameter. Now, it's the parameter as a string, and so if you want it as a number, you'll need to convert it to a number. But opt-arg is going to be a pointer to the string of the parameter. And then opt-ind, which is the index of the next flag, and this is useful for checking for extra arguments at the end, in particular things like file names. which is going to be super useful for projects 1 through 4. So this is what the example would look like using getOpt. So we, inside of our loop now, instead of looping over the string array argv manually, now we're going to just make repeated calls to getOpt, and we're going to save the option, the flag that we get back in a variable called opt, and we're going to keep looping as long as that value that we get back is not -1. And then we're just going to kind of take a switch on OPT. If it's A, we're going to set A flag. B, we're going to set B flag. Anything else, we're going to report an error. And then when we're done, so we're done with all of the flags, then we're going to look at opt IND, which is going to be pointing to the next, the index of the next command line argument. And if it is not the last one, so in other words, if there is no file name at the end, or if there are multiple file names at the end, we want to report an error and just abort at that point. Otherwise, we know that we can take that index and use it to extract that file name, and we don't have to worry about, we've already verified that there is actually a file name there. Now, the file name might not exist, so we'll need to check for that separately, but at least we verify that that the user did provide a file name. And this is much more robust. This actually handles way more error conditions than the original version that we had. And so we're going to be very much recommending that you use getOpt in this course for handling command line parsing.